Yeah, good afternoon, folks. What we have here is another arbor. This is going to be a stubby one. I got some cutters on eBay. Here's one of the cutters here. And this little area right here is the, we're going to thread this 8 threads per inch. This is a little stub that fits into the bearing that holds the whole thing. And I've got this arbor cut taper. Next thing, what I got to do is go over here to these gears. Change the gears out to 8 threads per inch. And then cut the threads on this. Then I'm going to have to bore out a piece. Probably this right here. Something like that. I've got several of these. I'll have to bore about a 1-inch hole in there and make myself a nut that will fit on there, and I should have another arbor. And then I've got a strange little, I don't know how well you can see here, but this is like a round keyway. I did find a keyway that would fit it, or a key that would fit it. Looks like it's about an 1/8 of an inch or something like that. See it right here offhand. And then I'm going to have to mechanically hand grind that thing to a round surface to fit in the gear. But anyway, that's the project now, is machine another arbor. Make us a couple more threaded parts, a bolt and a nut. And we're going to try to machine a little keyway in here with a cutter. Last time I paid my other machinist buddy to do it. So, but I have that arbor now. And, I don't know where it's at. There it is. And this one's already been machined for a 1/4-inch key. You can see there. So that'll be our next project, to make a little stubby arbor to fit that big cutter that's about that size. All right, well, this nasty job is kind of done. We've got it on low speed. We're just going to engage it here. Yeah, it looks like it's moving about right. So now I'll put in a cutting bit and try to make a little score on that thing, and then we'll get busy cutting threads. Alright. Well, I've got just have to take my word for it there. Let me see if I can back this out. I've got the Mr. Cutting Tool here all squared up with a fish. It doesn't look like it, but it really is. And I've got the point exactly on center. So I'm ready to start cutting threads. First thing I'm going to do is run in and take a little pass and check and make sure I got 8 threads per inch. Alright, I don't know if you can see it very well here, but I got my thread gauge here, 8 threads an inch, and it's lining up perfectly well. Now, I did this at the slowest speed but it's moving pretty fast. I think I'm going to put this in back gears here and try cutting these threads a little slower. Alright, I've made a couple passes here. What I've done, I've set my my crossfeed screw here at zero. That way I can come back to zero every time, and I'm going to take five in on this. That way, instead of plunging straight in to work, I'm actually plunging in and moving it over a little bit, so I'm only cutting on one side. So here's a technique. I'll back that out past zero. I'll go up here past my work someplace. I'm going to turn this back into zero. I'm going to give it 5/1000ths. I'm going to wait for a hole number to come up here. There's the one. And cut right on the where it's supposed to. I'll wait till I get to the middle. Stop it. Back it up. Go back to the beginning. Take it back to zero. Take another 5/1000ths. Wait for a whole number. There's two. And there's another cut. Wait for it to finish. Stop it. Back it up. Get to the front. Back to zero here again. Take another 5/1000ths. Wait for a whole number. There's the one. Take another pass. Wait to clear the threads. Back it up. Over the front. Take it back to zero. Take another 5/1000ths. Wait for a whole number. There's two. Right now. Cut another thread. Wait till I get to the end. Stop it. Now we just do this over and over until I get the threads down pretty close. So it's a little hard to do it with one hand. It's much faster if I just go ahead and put the camera down and do it. Now we're getting down here a ways. Starting to take off pretty good chunks. I thought you might want to watch. I've got it set up. I'm waiting for the hole number to come around. In this case, two. There it is. Taking off a pretty good piece of metal here now, as you can see. And there's the end of that. Back her out. Bring it over. Take it back into zero. Take another 5/1000ths. Wait for a whole number. Could be a number or a half a number, but I don't want to take a chance to mess up my threads. There's a whole number right there. I think it's any mark, but I don't remember exactly, and I don't want to chance it right now. Back it out. Take it over. Turn it down to zero. 5/1000ths. Remember, there's my number. I think maybe 2 more passes here. And then we'll back it out. Get it over. Back into zero. I made this dial here, by the way. Take another 5. Wait for a whole number. 1. Might be a 1000ths off here. Yeah, it's taking a pretty heavy cut. Got a little oil on it. I'm going to take one more just for the kicks. this time I'm only gonna take like 3 thousandths. That'd be 6 thousandths total, 3 thousandths per side. Wait for my whole number. Yeah, those threads are starting to look pretty sharp on top, which is a good indication that you're pretty much done. There's that. I'm gonna make one more. I'm not gonna crank any more in. I'm just gonna make a spring pass. Just a final cleanup cut, and then I'm gonna try to nut on it and see what I got. And there's my one. Shouldn't be taking too much now. Yeah, not much at all. Just a little cleanup cut. I might have to make one more pass, but for now, it's good enough to check it, see how close we are. I tried the nut, it didn't quite fit, so I took another thousandths, another 5 thousandths, I'm sorry, and a spring cut, and threads are pretty sharp looking right now. I'm gonna just run a file over them right now and clean them up, and then I'm gonna see if the nut will fit them. The nut will fit them. It was on there about halfway, third of the way, but it was not really working very well. Let's see if I clean this up a little and it should be all right now. All right, I'm not sure if I'm doing it right. I've got a little triangular file here. I'm just letting it run over the threads and manually taking it from side to side. The first side should be the roughest, which it feels like. That's where it was being pushed in, fed in. Yeah, it's moving up pretty good. Of course, the left hind face, there's no problem because that's a 60 degree cut from the toolbar. Feels pretty smooth. I'm not sure what I should be looking for, but I think that's about what I need. I'll try the nut on it and see how it works. Well, nut screws on good. It's don't have a lot of play. Goes right up to the shoulder and has a pretty firm hit. Got just enough there for the boy. That's pretty sharp. I probably ought to clean up that if I don't want to cut myself. But this should be perfectly good. Screws on and off well, tight. If I can make my nut now to fit this little bolt that I made, that'd be a good shape. Right now I'm gonna try putting that cutter on it and see how well that looks. Oh, Mr. Cutter here had a little trouble going over the shaft, so I emery just a little bit. I can't feel any play in there, and goes on nice easily. My nut tightens up. Not that the nut's going to hold it right now, but I have to make the next nut a little shorter than this, because I can barely got enough room here to put my my support bearing in. So I'll just measure this, and that's how big I'll make my next nut. So next part is to go to the milling machine over there and see if I can figure out some way of milling a slot in the shaft. And the next piece of lathe work will be to try to make a nut here to fit this thing. So we'll go on to our next step. Alright, well, I've got this approximately in the middle of that shaft. I've seen quite a bit of stuff on YouTube how they do that, but it looks like I just bring it down till it touches off and move it back and forth until I've got the exact width of the cutter cut into the metal there, and that would be the exact center. I could do some kind of edge finder stuff and fool around with it and this and that and the other thing, but I don't have any of that. I just have to do a lot of measuring. So I'm just going to try now to set this up at, get it on center. And this surface right here is going to be where part of the wrench goes. So I'm going to groove it all the way through that if I can. This cutter was kind of messed up, and I'll groove this one down in here as far as I can for the, before I get into the threads. Anyway, time to fire up the mill and see what I can do. Alright, I see how this works. You see down in there, it's not quite the width of the cutter. And I'm right now on the 27, I'm going to take it to 30. And I'm just going to run this back and forth here. Alright, that there looks like it's just about the width of the cutter. So we're going to call it down here on the bottom, 30 is zero, or the center of the shaft. And we'll just take this one in till it's exactly the same on both sides. Can't really see with this camera. And right there, the cut disappears. And now I got a light here I put in. I should be using it, I suppose. My cut there just disappeared, just appeared here, just disappeared. I think for a keyway, that's plenty good enough right there. So I'm gonna lock my gibbs and see what I can do about cutting the slot now. Well, this is working. This back to, I've got it set here about zero right there, and I'm just taking in about ten thousandths, give it some feed. I've got it feeding pretty slow. This is messy, but it's like it's cut. cutting and it's not running too hot. Kind of hard to tell what I'm getting, but I'm pretty sure I'm cutting a slot in it. Just keep this up for a while. I was trying running it a little faster, but looks like pretty good speed. It's cutting 15 or 20 thousandths, which is good enough for what we're after. And I'll run this back to my zero. Yeah, maybe a little more. Next one. There's my zero. 10,000, I'm going to go for 15. Alright, there's 15. Engage it. Throw a little oil on it. It's a messy. Job, but I'm pretty sure it's cutting. The only thing it might not be is pushing this shaft down in the vise. I don't have anything under it, but I do have it tightened up pretty good there in that bead. Actually is cutting. We'll do a little check here. My little guess stick. Cord this on about 75 thousandths deep. I'll have to do a little checking with the gear and stuff and see how much I need to do. Well, here we are with the keystock and the gear. According to this, it's about 110, but I need to put a round surface on here, so that's going to be my next thing, is try to grind a round that'll match that and see how things go there. All right, I kind of ground this key down to a round, and I've got it tapped into the shaft here. My next step is just to see if this is going to work. Looks like it's fitting pretty tight. I don't really want to use any force. I'm putting it on. Looks like it's hitting the pin there a little bit. Maybe I can just use a little force. I can always get it off. I use a rubber hammer here. Yeah, it's going on pretty easily. Look like it's what it's doing is driving the pin out of this end. Means that the pin is a little bit too big. So I'll see if I can see where it's hitting here. Right there on the end. Looks like I just don't have enough round on it. I'll try grinding it a little more. Try it again. Yeah, much better this time. It's got 3/8 of an inch. And let's try tapping it on. Looks like it's going on real well. Pin's not moving. Rub to the threads. It looks like I'm doing pretty well here. Let's see if I can get it on all the way, and then we'll just put it in the head here and see what we can get done. Alright. Grab me a... Got a piece of... Piece of stock I'm gonna trim down and make a nut out of. The end is pretty messed up. It's taking a while for me just to go back and forth here and clean it up. I know this carbide is not supposed to do very well at interrupted cuts, but remember, we're getting pretty good at it. I think what I'm going to do is just clean up the end here and then drill a hole in it. Taking a pretty good cut there. I have to go slow. I'm doing this by hand. And then once I get the hole drilled, that'll give me less to cut off. And I'll probably cut it off before I thread it. I'm not sure. Anyway, that's all I'm doing now is just trimming this down to make a nut out of it. Kind of boring. Catch up when I got it closer. Alright, I gotta drill all the way through. This is a 5/8 Morse 2 taper, Morse taper 2. I'm just feeding this in by hand here. I'm not paying attention to what I do, locked it up. It's running about 380 right now. 400 RPM. Getting pretty nice looking chips off of it. Still trying to run a little too fast, I think. So I'll pay attention to what I'll do to finish boring this hole. Well, I need a minor diameter of 860. Measure this bit here. It's about 780, 790, something like that. So I've lowered it down to next lowest speed. Looks like the bit's turning in the truck a little bit. Throw a little oil in it, see if that helps. Well, have to reseat that. Well, this is not one of the best Morse taper size number 2 here that I ever saw. It's a pretty rough. A machinist friend of mine told me that. There's a trick, you can wrap them with paper, newspaper is what he said, and apparently supposed to give it some more grip. And it could be that this bit also is not all that sharp. I have worked on it, but I think it's mostly here in the taper. So I'm going to put a little piece of paper on it and see if I can get it a little to hold better. Paper, it just made it worse. So I cleaned it up with a file. This is a good truck. It's a bad taper. I'll have to get me another good taper. But at least it's going through. Put some more oil on it, see if I can't get this squealing to shut down some. Yeah, a little oil and a higher feed rate. Going through pretty good. Need to do this two-handed though. Put down this camera. Alright, I got several different kinds of bars, but just bought the bullet and sprung for an indexable boring bar. I've got this little block here. It's got a groove in the bottom, so it should center it. So I'm going to try to tighten this down and see how well this carbide insert will work. Alright, I got it in here and tightened up pretty good. I got a lot of an extension here. It's probably not too good, but I want to bore through the whole piece, and I'm going to take my time doing it. So I've got several boring bars like this that are carbide inserted. They're cheap. They work, but I can tell that they're flexing. This one shouldn't flex at all. At least not any kind of power that I'll be putting through it. And I've got it set up right on center. We'll just give it a go now and see what we do get. First thing I'll do is just bring it in. I'll back it out until I touch off. Okay, it just touched off. Have to hand feed this whole thing. So I'm at 85. Let's back it out to just 5 thousandths. The reason I'm hand feeding it is because I've got the screw set up to thread. Now that's seems to be cutting real nice. Shatter, no nothing. Of course, trying to do it one-handed is not the best deal. So I'm going to put the camera down and try it some more with both hands so I can get a little smoother. I have to say, it just works beautiful. Even by hand, made a really nice cut through there. Nice and smooth and even. Let's see what we got now. It looks like 7:30. And my minor diameter here is 8:60. 7:30 from 8:60. Well, I got over 100 thousandths to go. So it took 20 thousandths pretty good last time. I'll just crank in another 20 and make a couple more passes. I'll make cranking 20. That's 10 on each side. It'll be 80 thousandths, and it'll be pretty close. We'll check it again. All right, here's our existing nut. It shows us 860 roughly, and here I've got about 875. So I'm going to call that good enough. If it's a little loose, I really don't care. That's what I was shooting for, is 865, and that's what I got. So next thing, I've got another little jewel here that came. By the way, this is a Schar's Tool Company. I got this is a Schar's quick change, good tool bit. They seem to be very good tools. I think they're Chinese or not sure where, but have no complaints, and they're pretty cheap. This is a internal threading tool, which I bought specially for this, so I'll get this mounted up and see what happens. Well, here's our fancy brazed carbide internal threading tool. Looks pretty good. It'll mount right in there. Only trouble is that I'm about a quarter of an inch short being able to go through this whole thing. So I think I'm gonna, since I've still got this cutter in here, I'm going to try to just mill off a little bit with this setup I got. And hopefully I can do that without too much vibration. Now, I didn't think that was going to work. This is just too big to go in the vise. I'm going to try to grind it off. I only got about a quarter of an inch. Maybe I can grind it and not worry about milling it. Well, I had to modify this quite a bit. I did get it where it'll go all the way through. I had to cut the bottom off here quite a bit. I'm still not certain that this is going to be on center when I try to run it through here. I ordered a 3/8. They wrote me back and said they didn't have one, so I bought a 1/2 inch. I figured a 1/2 inch would be good enough for a 1 inch hole, but anyway, give it a little grind, and not a very pretty job. The grinder I've got is more suited for sharpening drill bits than it is trying to hog off a piece of stuff. I did the best I could there. It's going all the way through. I have to be careful. As soon as it gets close to that edge, it will hit. I probably ought to take a little taper out of that. And as far as the up and down, I think I'm about the center. So I'm going to chamfer this a bit and make a little test pass across there and see what happens. All right, we're in medium speed back gears. I've got this one just touched off here at 55. Got my cross slide at 0. And this one, I'll be threading the cross slide out. Hope that's right. It's the only way it can be. Seems like it would be kind of backwards. Anyway, I'm going to wait down here until I get a whole number come around and you describe, there's two. There she goes. You gotta be ready to pull this thing out the second that it comes out of here. Alright, there's the end, and there's the teeth. So far, so good. Let me get out of there and see what I did. Well, it's making threads, but I think the problem is with me feeding it in on the cross slide, I should probably be cutting from the back to the front. So I'm actually kind of going at it backwards here. I don't know how I would resolve this. The only thing I could think of is to take it back here. Oops. I got this set to 55 to 0. Wrong way. Take it all the way back into here. Bring it out to my zero point. Change my feed. So I'm going the other way. Try to make a pass from the back to the front. See what happens there. Well, that's making a little difference. Couple things I had to see, my zero's at 55. Bottom of my little cutting bar was actually touching the threads, and so the bottom of the bar was messing it up, and I was cutting the wrong way. But now I'm taking 10-15 thousandths off at a time. Now let's see, here's 10-15. You can hear when it engages. I'll wait for an even number here. You can hear it's cutting a nice even pull. Nice chip coming off of it. I may have messed up that thread a little bit in the beginning, but whatever I'm cutting now will be a good thread. I just hope I can save the piece. We'll see in a little bit. Well, so much for this. Now this is going to focus here. Where's my tool bit? Down towards the end. There it is. You can see that somehow that little carbide tip got broke off. And I've got kind of a mess inside of there. Kind of semi-double threaded and everything else. So, don't really know how to make the inside nut. Back to YouTube, and I can probably straighten this little tip up here with a grinder and a gauge, hopefully. And back to the drawing board for this. Well, here we are, semi ready to start again. I just cut another piece here and machined it, bored it out here with a funky little boring bar to the diameter of our nut. One of the things that didn't make sense is why my thread wasn't being cut good yesterday. And everything I tried to do made it worse. So I got to looking at YouTube and on threading, and turns out I've got this set correctly for external threads. There's two ways that you can set this up, probably more than that, but one of them is turning this 30 degrees this way for an internal thread. And of course now everything is going to interfere over here on the chuck end. The other solution is to go to a 30 degree way this way and then feed it into the work from this direction. So at least I can read that pretty easily. That's what I'm going to do, is set up this whole business here to feed from this side. Where'd my little, I kind of ruined my little boring bar, or my little threading bar here, but I was able to put it on a drill, and I mean on the grinder, and I've cut a reasonably good 60 degree angle in there, and I'm pretty sure that this will be able to thread properly. Close enough for what I want anyway, I hope. So I'll get this set up and I'll bring it back to when I start threading this nut again. Well, here's the first problem. There's only one mark on this thing. Now why in the world the engineers decided to put this mark in the back of the lathe, it just don't make no sense at all. But there's where it's at, and I have no mark. I should have one here on the side. At least I can read that one. And I've cleaned this off good right here. There's nothing there, and there's nothing really there, so I'm gonna try to mark this as accurately as I can. I've got it set on 90 on the back right now. All I need is some kind of a mark to have a reference. So I'm gonna try to do something with this now and bring it back when I got that done. Well, I managed to get two marks. I can't know if you can see them here. There's one here, and then I used a, well, it's got a good zoom, and I used a center punch here. I actually need to make a little plate or something with a little pointer and screw it on here, make something a little bigger, better than that. But anyway, this will be good enough to get something close to where I want it. This is supposed to be 30 degrees this way, or half of a 60 degree thread. So let's see what we got here. I can't really see. It's 40. We'll probably do better off looking at the camera. Oh, there we go. That would be 60 there. I'm about a degree off on the center. All right. That should give me a 30. That looks better. That would be half. That looks like it's where it's supposed to go there. Alright, so right at 30 degrees. Close enough for what I'm going to be doing, which is threading. And at least we'll be cutting it the right way this time, hopefully. Well, let's get it finished setting up and come back to it. Alright. Got it in high back gears. Got everything zeroed. I got my cross light here. My, this is at zero. It's just barely starting to touch. Everything's all tightened down. I'll just fire it up. Engage my feed, make sure I'm going the right way here, wrong way. I'll wait for a, here's a two. It's through. I'll turn this in, back it out, bring it back to zero. Take another 10 thousandths here. Here's the number. Finished. Take it in, back it out. Back to zero. Another 10 thousandths. There's the number. There's the number. Even touching anything yet. Doesn't make any difference. Sooner or later I will. Take another 10 thousandths. Number two. Good enough, alright. So I'm going to pull around here with some settings and I'll get this video actually cutting something. Well, we're sort of progressing. Kind of ruined its tip earlier. Snapped it off and tried to regrind it. I guess it's pretty close. I'm just going in 10 thousandths now. Wait until my whole number comes up. I'm making one cut. Here it goes. See, it's really pulling it down. You can see it snap out when it passes. Just too much pressure on it. Back it out. Bring this back to zero. I'm going to do one spring cut here. I'm not going to feed it in anymore. There's one. So that's what I'm doing. I'm taking one cut and then a spring cut. And I will take five off this time. Should have 10. And even five, it's pulling. Because of that bit that I put in there, it's really not very good. I think I ruined it. But, there's my one. But with any luck, I can hope that one side is good enough to cut me one nut. I'll just press on and see what happens. Well, here's after a bunch of passes. This bit is cutting. It's way too much tool pressure. It's not cutting like it should, but it is cutting. And I'm going to try to see if this thing will thread on something. Let's see what we got. Alright, here's the shaft it needs to fit. It's starting. It's only going in maybe one turn and it gets really tight. So I'm going to take a couple more passes here and see what I can do about making this thing fit a little better. But at least it's closed. Well, I made a few spring passes. One thing I did do is tighten the gibs here on the cross slide, which made it cut quite a bit more than what it was. But the fact is, this is not the tightest screw in the whole world. You can see a wiggle around there, but it screws in real nice. Tightens up, and of course there's no movement once it's tight. So the next thing is to machine me a couple flats on this so I can put a wrench on it, and we'll give it a test and see how well it works. Alright, we're in the mill here. Made my first touch off pass here. Take a 5/1000ths. I'm not sure about that cutter. And I should be milling a pretty decent flat on this thing. Just for a tool to grab the nut with. Might speed it up a little. Sound too bad. That's taking a decent flat. I'm gonna take another 5 and see what happens. And I think that speed's a little fast for that size of the cutter. I'm going to try 10/1000ths this time. I'm going to pull that speed down a little. That sounds a little better. Chips. Pretty decent surface. Like I say, I don't know how good that cutter is. I'm gonna try another 10/1000ths. I'd rather take it a little slow and get it done than burn up one of my cutters or something. These things are expensive, even these old used ones that aren't really any good anymore. Taking its sweet time. I'm going to try to hand feed this one. That's just throwing out a little bigger chips. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to speed this feed up a little bit and try it again. Alright, that's the next fastest speed. I'm going to try another 10,000th. And only thing is feed rates changed. I put it from next to the lowest speed. I have no idea what that is. I guess one of these days I need to measure everything and see. Seemed to take it pretty well. I'm going to turn this down just a little. Try another 10,000th. See what's happening with a little slower speed. Got some pretty good vibration going on. I'm gonna tighten this back. Yeah, that made a little difference. So it looks like that whole shaft being tightened up helps a lot. Well, let's run her through. We'll just take another 10,000th for the fun of it. There's 10. Alright, let's go 15. 15,000th. Same feed, same speed. The only thing I did do is tighten this down. Yeah, that's got a little jerking in the table. So it looks like it's taking 15,000ths pretty good. I'm going to try one more 15,000ths and I'm going to call it good on that side. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Taking 15,000ths. Yeah, let's see, 5, 10, 15,000ths. Blowing out some pretty decent chips over here. Pulsing in the table. Probably right at about the maximum that this cutter can take, or this machine can take. 15,000ths. 5, 10, 15, another 15. And did find out that a little oil helps. Probably need to set myself up a cooling system on this. mess, but for now, good enough. I don't know what I'm gonna pull this out of here. See how much I cut on the other side. I was at 0 and 15 on the other side. I'm at 0 15 now, but I don't know how much I moved it down. Alright, I measured them. I had 100 thousandths depth on the other side. This guy is about 85. So I need to take 15 thousandths off one more pass. And that'll be good for him. $15,000. Run her through the thing here. Fire up her motor. Dial in $15,000. This should give us exactly 100 thousandths cut. This is a lot more accurate than the lathe as far as the dials and stuff go. Pretty much what I've measured on them, and then I cut pretty much exactly what I got. Of course, this is a machine designed for milling. It's not flexing as much as that lathe. Alright. That should give me 100 thousandths. And Mr. Gas Stick. There we go. Yeah. 5,000 short, but that's probably in where I'm measuring it. That's 10 over there. Oh, no. There's 0. That's good enough. All it is for a wrench. So that nut is done. Now I need to machine a flat on the other shaft, something like this, and I'll set that up with this same miller, hopefully. All right. There's a second bass. 50 thousandths on each side. Looks pretty good. And I'll clean this up now, and should have a completed spindle. Next thing will be to try the big cutter. But right now, I think I'm gonna take a little break and sit down. My back's killing me. I've been at this all morning. Well, here's Mr. Milling Cutter, all set up, ready to go. I'm gonna fire it up, touch off here, piece of mild steel. I'm gonna take 7 thousandths and engage it. See what this thing does. Nice big fat cutter. Probably just taking off the edge of the piece right now. 7 thousandths is not much. We can speed it up quite a bit, I'm sure. Shatter in the, or vibration in the table. chip there. Finish running it in by hand. I'm getting quite a bit of back and forth pulsing here. I don't know if the tighten up the gibbs will do it, or what's actually causing that. I've got it where it's pretty snug. Pretty tight down at this end anyway. A little rattle in my drive here at the full extended position. We're going to take another 5 off and engage it. See what we got here. Mild steel. No lubricant. Now this is a staggered cutter, left and right. I don't know what the significance of that is. I'm just going to try to square up this piece of steel with it. Looks like it's doing pretty good, and then I'm going to try to put it in there and make a pass across a big flat spot, use the entire width of the cutter, see what happens. Well, 10,000th is throwing off a pretty good sized chip. Still got quite a bit of pulsing going on here. Tried tightening the gibbs. It's hard to crank right now. I don't think we're gonna do much better than this. Pull it down a little bit. Try another 10. See what happens here. Alright. I tightened up the vertical gibbs. All of the bolts on it, they weren't really all that tight. Alright. Cleaned up that one side, put it in the vise good. I'm going to try to machine all the surfaces square here. So this will be the first side here, our second side. Take another 5. This cutter seems to be working real well. Taking a 1-inch pass here, 5,000. See, we're getting pretty good sized chips. Need to figure me out some kind of a pan or something to catch this. I still got a lot of junk here. I need to get some shelves up here. Get all this stuff on the wall. I guess in the meantime, it wouldn't hurt nothing to just put a board on this. I can still get to the controls. Catch some of the chips here. Don't look like it's we'll probably speed this up quite a bit. Yeah, that looks like it's a better cutting speed for thickness we got. Good enough. We'll run this back through here again. Looks like 5,000ths at speed 6 is pretty good. Quite a bit of rattle out of my U-joint here at the maximum extension. Now we'll take another 5, gauge the feed. Doing real well. If I run the XY in, I can run it right up to there. Probably machine a little off that bias if I had to. Blade on the bottom. Got 3130 this end, 3128, 3125, 3137. I don't know whether this is turn it over on the other side. It's 3135 25. Okay, about 10,000ths difference between one side and the other, which could be easily the what's happening and setting in that vise. I'll try to make another pass here on each side and see if I can't square that up a little better. I stuck a little piece of keystock there in the vise. Hopefully that would be holding this against the solid jaw. Didn't even touch this end and it started to cut on the other end. thousandths right now. Put a little oil on it. Just blowing off some pretty good chips. Getting a little pulsing. Mostly in the table itself. Everything else looks to be pretty solid. Alright, this is 5 thousandths fast now. Speed it up a little. I don't see my oil smoking or anything, so should be running pretty cool. And we're blowing up fairly small. A bit of pulsing left. I think that might be just the nature of this staggered cutter. But I think this will be the last pass on this side. I think that'll probably square it up pretty good. Yeah, it looks fairly uniform. Of course, this is just probably a piece of hot rolled steel. Feels good. It's nice and smooth. I can see just the tiniest hint of the pulsing in there. Let's see if I can zoom in. Yeah, you really can't. Yeah, you can see just a couple little tiny waves in there. You can see them with the eye a little bit, but not with the camera. You can't feel them at all. So looks like this milling cutter is going to work out just fine. If I don't use a vise, I've got the edge of my table here. Zooming the wrong way. I've got the edge of the table's about right here, and that's about where the edge of my cutter is. Then I can still move the table in, so I can machine from this end of the table to the end of the cutter here. And cutter looks fine. No chips, no nothing I can see here. So it looks like this little arbor test here was quite a success. I'm going to do one more flip here and see if I can check the other side. I did check between these two sides here with the calipers, and they're within 3/1000ths of each other. So that's good enough for my work. I think that's really all the tests that I'm going to need to do with this arbor and this cutter. Works out just fine. And so we had a successful day's work. This nut I made works just fine. The arbor seems to be holding good and not skipping or anything like that. So I would say this was a successful arbor and cutter test.